Welcome to WHU Inside Business. We are here today with Alexander Hendorf. He's a partner at Koenigsweg. Alexander, thanks very much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for the invitation.
There's a lot of talk about artificial intelligence. I would like to start us off with your perspective on how does AI affect managers today? And where do you see the biggest potential in the future?
Yeah, AI is a big game changer. We have to see AI is not there since 2 years ago. It's a very old technology. It dates back to the 40s. There's a huge potential now, like building proper processes, data management, drawing information with AI systems out of your business data for more insights, automating the boring stuff, especially creating extra value, more insight, and also less humanly biased data, bringing new insights into your data, not just like from basic analytics. Let me give you one really good example everybody knows from hospitals. We are really good at frequentist math. So if something happens, we are really good to present. But the humans are really bad in understanding like preconditions, as we have like in if you look into the Bayesian space, for example. But we know Bayesian space and Bayesian math. If you go to a hospital or to the doctor, they ask, oh, do you have any preconditions? And if we try to calculate or get a feeling about how much do preconditions influence the outcome, we are really bad with our thinking and stats. So with like artificial intelligence, machine learning, the whole space provides a lot of these methods, just like getting a better insight and grasp how your business works, where values are. You can basically get information from inside, from the outside. It's a very big space.
Very interesting. What do you think, what role does company culture play for making deployment of artificial intelligence successful?
Well, actually, I think as you say in German, it's half the rent, actually. It's not, making AI happen is not only a technical challenge, right. It's a human challenge. There's many stakeholders involved. You need, everybody on the team has to have an understanding about what the technology can do, and also like to make a difference. Okay, this is the technology and this is science fiction. This is a supplier overpromising, and also like refocusing which is the real value we want to perceive or like to gain for our company. And of course, the whole process should be built in diverse teams, because the world is getting more and more complex. Everything is getting more and more individualized. So of course, building the right product, having the right insight gets more and more difficult. So we need many people to look at the data, to the outcome, to see, to have like, to do a quality control here. So it's actually team play. And actually many people forget, for example, we have this new initiative with Gaia X. Yeah. Camus sharing, anonymized data. Yeah, it sounds like a good plan, but what is data if you don't have the context? Because the data is basically almost every time worthless if you cannot talk to the domain expert, if the context is missing. Only if you have the context, you can see, okay, what is the use case? Why are there outliers? We see in ministry, at Koenigsweg, we see, for example, in industry products, predictive maintenance, we see sensors are not just like sensors. It depends on the model, how they react. So there's actually many people on the shop floor also involved. Electricians have to be involved in these projects. So it's a team effort. It's a company effort. So the company culture should be very open, open communication, respectful, of course. And you have to listen to the silent people as well, because usually they give you the better insights. It's a big social challenge as well. The tech is only half of it.
Right. What are some of the biggest misconceptions that you have come across in your consulting practice?
They usually very often from Koenigsweg, when we go to a client very often, they ask you us for the latest tech. We are very active and very visible, especially in the Python and PyData communities. Yeah. So of course they know, they are experts, they know about the latest tech, they have all the access to the experts building this tech. And then we say, yeah, well, why do you want to use this technology? And they said, yeah, we think it's the best solution. And we have always have to point out, the newest technology is not probably always the best solution, maybe, but let's try like more proven methods first before we look into the latest space of deep learning. Can we solve it with regression? Can we, and basically, what's your data model and what's the real use case? And actually also like asking, because sometimes people want to try out and play technologies, and we always ask, okay, what is the value you want to have? And very often, for example, in one industry project, it was no. Actually, it's not about prediction or the prediction. Actually, it's like we want to have improve our relationship with our customers again. Mm-hmm. So we will provide this free data service. So for our customer relationship, to do more business with them, also to have more maintenance business with them. So we basically give this away for free if you buy a machine from us.
What does the new development in terms of data science, machine learning, AI mean for us, for instance, as a business school or for kind of the broader education landscape?
Yeah, as everything, businesses, we have to be more agile, we have to be more open, we have to be very flexible with everything nowadays. And also I think as a business school, you have to look, okay, evaluate what are new technologies, which technologies are there to include in our curriculums, and also of course like what's the basic grounds to build on to understanding new technologies faster, because we are moving, especially driven by open source, we have like so much innovation currently, it's awesome, but of course it can be also exhausting. There's a new neural network every day, it could be very useful, you need to I think it would be also like good like to teach how to basically separate the signal from the noise. Okay. Mm-hmm. So AI, there's so much noise because cloud providers, everyone wants to do the new business. So we have a lot of we see a lot of over promises in the market as well.
Okay. Yeah, that seems to be a crucial task kind of for.
Yeah, I mean, it's their job to sell, but yeah. I mean, like over promising. Usually we try not. One of our ground values is now to always to be upfront. That's why we call the company also like Koenigsweg. Yeah, so it's the best way for the king, for the customers, the king. And we always said, no, we will be very upfront about everything, not to oversell, because only a returning customer is a good customer.
Okay. Yeah, absolutely. if you recruit new employees, what skills are you looking for?
Oh, multiple skills. Of course, expertise in a domain. Of course, like how driven people are. Of course, also a lot of like social skills. It depends. We don't have like fixed profiles. Right. So usually it's a team decision. For example, if we hire a new working student, we think, okay, is it a good addition to the team? Yeah. If we bring another consultant in, said, okay, is this a good fit for the team? Will the communication work? Of course, also expertise. But usually people also grow in projects. So it's basically you need to have like a ground skill set, and the rest, yeah, we can help. We play as a team.
Okay. Where do you see AI in 10 years?
Maybe it's what was AI again? No, actually, I think it will be part of our lives. Right. Probably not as in science fiction movies. Maybe we won't have any Alexas anymore. We will see if this technology moves beyond selecting playlists, because this is something which is probably overrated. I think there will be a lot of AI which we will not really perceive as AI anymore, because it's the service. Actually, we are already using AI systems for decades and we are not aware of it. It's just like now after with having data, having more computational power, having open source software, having open research, of course we have a big AI boom, and of course now usually people are over expecting. We'll see what will really work, but I think we will have great value, especially because we have data to make decisions on, or we have systems that assist you, as can assist us in certain ways. For example, if you think about simple thing like an agent in a call center, or you receive a customer email, probably is upset. AI, natural language processing, can help you to pre-classify what is the customer, why, what's the context. It can even like provide context, what is the process, what is the need. So basically, the benefit here, the agent can fully focus on the human interaction without being stressed out. Okay, I have to make so many calls, I have to look this up, I have to see these things. So basically, you can have like a relaxed agent focusing on human-to-human interaction, calming things down probably if the customer is upset. So I think AI can help us in many ways to kill boring routine stuff and more focus on creativity, human interaction ideas. AIs are not really good at ideas. They can only basically regenerate things we know already, at least in most cases. So I think it can be a big relief. So we can have a lot of extra value, and it's very often overseen. Of course, if you have an AI model that works, you can scale it. Mm. So basically, it's a business model of many companies, as Google. They say, we have this AI service, it's an API, it costs you only a few cents, but actually you can scale it horizontally, and it's a billion-dollar business. Yeah. And that's very often overlooked. And the question for many companies is, do you just want to be somebody who buys from these suppliers and they have the value out of AI, or do you see some potential to build your own systems, right, for example? Of course, it's R&D, it's an investment, it's a risk, yeah. but if you have an AI model that can scale and it can provide business services to others, it's basically, it's electricity in the cloud, and very scalable business. So it can be very profitable as well.
Yeah, so that sounds exciting and like a great opportunity here. Thanks very much, Alexander, for joining us.
Yeah. Thank you for inviting me.
Excited to hear about your perspectives on AI.
Thank you. All right.